old. Versus new. Welcome to the ultimate Mercedes AMG S63 comparison video. We took both the older and the new Mercedes AMG S63 coupe today, and I'm going to take you around both of them and show you the changes. I know that, you know, people always say, well, those facelifts, those LCIs, you never really see it. They are such little changes. But I'm here to tell you that when you have them side by side and when you drive them back to back, there are actually quite a lot of changes. And especially with this one, there are big, big changes. So we'll start at the back and we'll start with the looks. So I think the biggest improvement exterior wise of this car, of the new one compared to the old one, is that we have these new OLED tail lights. So we've got those layered light panels, which look really, really good. I think this is a very handsome rear end. We've also got a new rear bumper, especially on the lower end of the bumper. You can see that it has sort of a double diffuser with this piece going from side to side and air coming through here. We've got chrome exhaust tips on this one, black exhaust tips on this one, because this one has the AMG Night Pack. You just heard the sound that comes out of both of them. This of course has the old 5.5 liter V8 biturbo, and the new one has the 4 liter V8 biturbo. So maybe a little bit more trickery on this one, but this sounds definitely, it sounds much more aggressive. It's louder, it has crackles and bangs. And this is more old school AMG. It's very low, it's a bit muscle car. And well, we love both of them, really. Okay, so let's walk towards the front, but let me just get one thing out of the way. Now I have both these wheels on camera. They look really good, both of them matte black. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 spoke on that one. And this is the new design for the S-Class AMG. I really love that wheel. But they are both fake center locks. So this, usually with a center lock, this is supposed to be turned with a special wrench. But it's not. This is a cover, and underneath here are the regular bolts. So I don't really like that. They look cool, but it's fake, so don't really like that. So this is the new badge, V8 biturbo, 4MATIC Plus. We saw that on the regular S63 as well, the limousine. But it's not the 4MATIC Plus system we know from the E63 with the drift mode. So it does have the variable power delivery from front to back and vice versa, but not the drift mode. We've got steel brakes on this one, on the new one. And if we take a look around here, at the old one, we can see the golden calipers, which means that this has ceramic brakes. And the old badge right here, V8 biturbo, no 4MATIC badge, although this does have 4MATIC, but that was an optional extra on this car. You could get it, but you don't get a badge. So if we take a look at the front, there are a couple of changes again. The front apron, so the lower part of the bumper, is redesigned, so a bit more aggressive. And it's a bit more forward. If you look at it like this, you see that it's a bit more to the front and a bit larger as well, with these big air ducts and some coolers behind that. And we've also got a new grille design for the new S63. And this one has the optional Pan America grille, which I think looks insane. And that one has just a regular old S-Class grille. So this old one also has, as an option, these Swarovski crystals inside the headlight. Yep, a very Mercedes. And this one doesn't, so new headlight unit as well. And well, let's take a look at the engines. So we'll open this one up. If we can find it. Here it is. Okay, so in here we have the old V8 5.5 liter M157, and in here is the new 4 liter V8 biturbo M178 with that hot V with the turbos inside the cylinder bank. You've heard it all before. If you want some more information on the S63 limousine, click up here for a POV review of that one. So this old one, 5.5 liter V8 biturbo, 585 horsepower, 900 newton meters, and it has a 7-speed automatic gearbox. And if we move over to the new one, this one has that 4 liter with 612 horsepower and also 900 newton meters, linked to a 9-speed speed shift automatic gearbox. So all the new Mercedes models, the E-Class, the S-Class, all get that new 9-speed gearbox. So let's close it up. And let's check out the interior of this one first. So, this is one hell of an interior. I mean, the spec, this is crazy. We've got these huge seats in brown, sort of a caramel color, mocha, really, really lovely. And we've got this black, piano black stuff on the sides running all the way across to the other side with those pinstripes inside. Burmester audio and the old AMG steering wheel. You'll see the new one when we get over there. And let's, we also have the older screens, so two 12.3 inch screens, but you can really see the difference in resolution when you get into that one, so keep your eye on that. And well, down here we've got the controller and this touch thing with the old infotainment menu, and really not that much configurability. We've got this button for sport, manual and comfort for the gearbox. We've got sport and comfort for the suspension, the ride height, and that's it. This is the old key as well. We've got a new key, so this has been around for a long time, this key. And we've got the AMG logo in here, of course, which, yeah, it's really quintessential AMG to have that here. But this is one hell of a spec. I really love this. This is gorgeous. Okay, let's, wow, is that a Swarovski crystal as well? Or just glass or plastic? Well, it's shiny. Okay, let's take a look at the new one. And you will see the difference immediately, I think. So let's start with the new steering wheel with this aluminium right here and all around these buttons. I think this is a really good looking steering wheel. The spec is a bit less exciting than that one. So black leather all around and a lot of carbon fiber going from here across the dashboard to there. And well, pretty much the same seats as in the old one, but we've got a lot more to configure down here. So we've got the driving modes from individual, comfort, sport, sport plus to race. And you can see everything up there. And, well, the resolution of these screens is a lot better. The infotainment system is better. We've got a lot more of these sort of animations showing you what you've got and what it's about. And, of course, this has a glass panel in front of it now. So it doesn't have that separate screen look anymore like that one. It's more one screen, or that's what they want to show you, really. Okay, so I think that's it for the exterior and the interior. I think we'll take that one for a drive right now on the Autobahn and see what it's like. So let's get in here. Oh yeah, this is awesome. Especially when you get in this and then into that one and back. You know, that's when you really see the differences. Okay, so let's lower this, start it up. Okay, put that in drive, this in sport. And that's it, I think. Yes, it is. Okay, let's go. Alrighty, already got some crackles going from the exhaust. Oh my god, it's completely empty here. Very nice. Okay, so we'll pull away from here. Oh, this is quick as well. Holy moly. Okay, so there we go. 180. 190, 200, 210, 220, 230, 250. Okay, so this is what I love about the S63. Being a coupe or a limousine, I don't care. I love the fact that this does this so easily. It's so comfortable. It's so fast. I mean, we're at 300 already right now. It's just, it does it so well. 3.6, 3.7, my god. Holy moly. Something I do notice is that exhaust note is not that intrusive here when you get up to speed. I think the new one will be a lot louder inside. These downshifts, of course, you do hear. Kick down, no downshift. This actually has the AMG driver spec, so that means we've got a top speed of 300. 3.7 as we just saw. Maybe I'll get some more on the way back. So we'll turn around here. Okay, yeah, I remember this. This gearbox is really laggy. The shifts themselves are not bad. But the reaction to the pedal is really laggy. Okay. But this is what I love about this engine. If you select a gear, you know, one gear too high, and you have that really low burbling sound. This is what I love about this engine. We drove that AMG G63 recently, which also has this engine. Man, that just sounds so cool. And there's just nothing that sounds quite like an AMG. Little crackle on the downshift, and let's go. So this car will do 0 to 100 kilometers an hour in 3.9 seconds, which is pretty quick. Not as quick as the Duan, of course, but still very quick. Okay, let's see if we can reach anything more than 3.7. Not like this, of course. I am really, really enjoying this interior, guys. I think you are too, because this is, it's so amazing. It just, when you sit here, you see all that brown leather, you see those pinstripes in the corner of your eye. Oh, it just looks incredible. Okay, 270. Between old and new, so old and new, I knew. I mean, if old does it like this, if old gets up to 309 kilometers an hour this easily, yeah, I mean, it's just ridiculous. And that's the trouble that these car makers have, because these cars are so insanely fast and they do it so well and easily, and just, it's very hard for them to beat that. And then of course they do every time, which means that the new one is just a crazy beast. So Martijn drove this car to the Autobahn and he said you have to switch on the night mode because it's really cool. Ah, nice. I don't know if you can see it clearly, but those dials just turn away and they make room for the night vision cam, which is not bad actually. But I can tell you, because I have seen the one in the new one, it's even better. Okay, let's switch that off and open the window. First gear. Ah, this actually has a great steering feel. It is really incredible how they have done this. It just, man, you just feel where the car is. In such a large car is quite an achievement. Okay, so we will pull off here and get into the new one for a back-to-back comparison. And well, I'm very curious to see how that one drives after driving this one, because this is seriously impressive. And I kind of forgot how well this old one drives. Okay, so we will put this here and get out, and we'll get into this one. So I will open my window or keep the door open for the startup. Okay, so let's put it in Sport Plus Race. Let's put it in race and start it up. I mean, that's a big difference. It's much more aggressive. Okay, so let's go. We have it in race, so we also have launch control now. The old one doesn't have launch control. Okay, let's see what menu we want in here. So we like a rev counter and yeah, we'll take this one with the boost. And for this screen, you know, this is cool about the new one. You've got all these screen goodies. We'll use dynamic select and get the dynamic data. That's what they call it. Cool screen. So you can see now that this is the front axle, rear axle, and you can see that it powers the rear wheels now. It powers all wheels now, but it will switch off at higher speed. You'll see that later on. Okay, so we will wait here for a couple of minutes. No, because it's very empty again. Okay, so we'll start from here. Launch control, race start. Oh man, it's a bit wet, of course. So that's 0 to 100 kilometers an hour in 3.5 seconds, or well, it's probably not because it's wet, but it should be able in 3.5 seconds. Okay, that's 240, that's 250, 260. And we have to brake. So you immediately notice that that engine and exhaust are a lot more, well, audible. A lot of crackles, big sound. Shifts up automatically, and the response to the shifters, to the pedal shifters, is a lot better as well. Oh my god, it's limited! Don't tell me it's limited! We don't have the AMG driver's pack! Oh my god, that's so ridiculous! I hate that! I absolutely hate this! This is very disappointing. Okay, so here's a crazy conclusion for you guys. The old one is faster than the new one, because the new one is limited at 250 kilometers an hour and it will do 264-65 on the speedometer. So I think that's ridiculous. You've seen how quickly it gets to 260. I'm actually a bit angry. Okay, big sound, lovely, cool. Gearbox is a lot better than the old one. Yeah, yay, let's go to 250. Okay, so that's 240, 250. We have to get off here as well. Ooh, those brakes. I would love to have some ceramic brakes right now. The brakes are not great. I would recommend getting the ceramic brakes in addition to getting the AMG driver's pack, of course, because these brakes feel really spongy. Okay, move it. Oh, okay, let's play, baby. Okay, so although we don't have the drift mode like in the E63S, it does really allow for some playing around, which I like. Oh, that sound is really nice. Oh, there we go. This actually feels more punchy than the old one. It feels more aggressive, it feels more torquey, although they have the same amount of torque. This just feels a lot more modern, and that's the limiter. So, get on the gas again, on the throttle, And that's the limiter. 266, 265. Stupid limiter. I hate this limiter. So, you could be... Okay, so there could be like a Porsche 996 Carrera S with, what do they have, 400 horsepower? No, not even that. And they have a higher top speed than you do, and they will just overtake you and laugh in your face. And laugh in the face of your 612 horsepower Panamerica grill mouth. Yeah, okay. I just don't understand this, but let's move on. The way it gets to the limiter is really impressive. And like I said, the soundtrack is a lot more audible. Okay, so we're now in ninth gear, doing 264 top speed. And it's super comfortable. I mean, one hand on the wheel, a little wind from the side, and it just is so stable. Man, this is, it's a cool car. They both are. Okay, so we've got that tunnel over there. We're still in race mode. Let's see. Let's put it in manual. And let's see if we can get a rev limiter. Yes, we do. But it doesn't sound great. Okay, so the traction control is completely off right now. And it doesn't really put its tail out because you have that 4MATIC system, of course. But you really do feel that it's rear biased. And that's really good, of course, because that means that you have a really neutral handling. And yeah, it still feels like a rear driven AMG, although you do have the daily usability and the practicality of a 4MATIC system. Okay, so let's put the traction control back on and we'll get off here. So guys, this is it for this review. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something, and well, I hope you decided which one you are going to buy if you win the lottery, that one or this one. I love them both. They both have their qualities. And you can check out, well, what should we link up here? Check out another S-Class review up here. Or you could also check out, for example, the BMW M760 Li POV review up here with M driver spec. So enjoy those. You can subscribe by clicking on the little icon in the bottom right corner, and you can follow us on social media. I hope you do. I hope you sub if you are not a subscriber yet. And I hope to see you at the next one. Bye guys, thank you.